I have over 100 HomeKit devices in my house, and a lot of them are sensors. From contact sensors to tell if a door is open, a new vibration sensor I'm trying out on a washing machine, motion sensors to turn on lights in closets and patios, a new solar-powered pool sensor that's telling me the pH, chlorine, and other data, plus water leak sensors, outdoor weather temperature, and more. So in this video, I'm going to tell you 10 of the automations I use around my house using all these sensors. And before we jump in, don't forget to subscribe to the channel before you go. So first up is an automation that runs every time I enter my office. I actually have a contact sensor down by the floor, and this reads whether or not the door is opened. The contact sensor I'm using there is actually the Aqara Door and Window Sensor P2. It's a matter over thread sensor. It doesn't require the Aqara hub, and it's been super reliable because it uses thread. Now I have a bunch of automations programmed, and for this contact sensor, I'm gonna go to my home app and then over to the automations tab. I'm gonna be going over a bunch of these as we talk about the different sensors, but this P2 sensor is when the office door opens, and I have this automation run only during certain times of day, which is typically when I enter my studio. Not only can you add a time for an automation, but you can also choose if you want this automation to run when you are home, when nobody is home, and all different combinations there. But when my door opens between 7 and 8:30 a.m., it's actually gonna run my office work scene. It's helpful to create scenes for automations like this, because then if you add or remove devices to the scene, your automation is still gonna work. And just to show you, I'll jump over to my studio room so you can see the scene. And my office work scene, you'll see it opens my blackout shades, turns on my ceiling fan, and the ceiling fan light. Then I have a bunch of scenes for filming, which turns those off and turns on my filming lights. If you want to learn more about my studio automations, I'll put a video above and in the description. Next up is actually a new vibration sensor I'm trying from Aqara. This thing can detect when vibration starts and stops. I have an older washing machine and dryer, so I don't get notifications on my phone when it stops. So I put the vibration sensor on the side of the washing machine because it doesn't make any sound. And one of the triggers you can use for a HomeKit sensor is when it detects something or when it stops detecting something. So for this vibration sensor, I chose when it stops detecting motion, which means the washing machine has stopped running, it's stopped shaking. Again, you can specify the time or people, but I want this to run whenever because I want to know when the washing machine is done. Now, HomeKit doesn't have great built-in notifications for when sensors start or stop certain things, but you can create a shortcut based on this HomeKit automation. And then I actually use an app called PushCut to send me that notification when the washing machine stops. PushCut is a great app for customizing some notifications like this. I actually have a few of them. I have one on a mini fridge when the door is left open. So if you want to learn more about setting a PushCut with HomeKit notifications, I also have a video on that linked above and down below. Number three, I have a bunch of motion sensors around the house. This is the Philips Hue motion sensor. I have this in our pantry. And then I have other motion sensors like the Eve and others in different closets. One of the simple automations I have for this specific Philips Hue motion sensor is in the pantry. When motion is detected in that pantry, it turns the pantry light on. Super simple. I do a motion sensor rather than a contact sensor, which you could do a contact sensor on the door whenever door is opened, but sometimes the door gets left open. And if you walk into the pantry and the door was open just a crack, well then that contact sensor automation is not gonna run. So I find a motion sensor automation like this, especially when going into a closet that usually gets left open, is really reliable. One of my favorite sensors is this Aqara contact sensor. It's really inexpensive, super small and discreet. It does require an Aqara hub. I'll put links to one of those in the description, but you can get a 3-pack of these contact sensors for $42 on Amazon. It's a pretty great deal. One place where I have these contact sensors is the door going from our master bedroom to the patio because I want to know if that ever gets left open. Now this automation I actually have set up in the Aqara app because it has built in when doors are left open for a certain amount of time, just built right into the app. So here for this automation, you see the bedroom patio door contact sensor. If it's opened, and then you can easily set for over 3 minutes. So if the door opens and it's left open for 3 minutes or more, then the Aqara app is gonna send me a notification. If you're looking for using contact sensors to know when a door is open or not, setting those automations directly in the Aqara app is one of the easiest ways to do it. But if you just wanna use the Apple Home app and no third-party apps, another way to do it is how I'm using an Aqara contact sensor on the mini fridge out on the patio. If the mini fridge ever gets left open, that's not a good situation. So I have another automation here that's when backyard mini fridge opens. So the contact sensor will trigger this automation whenever it detects the door is open. And I have another shortcut here, but this time I actually have it wait 60 seconds as the first action because I want to know if the door was left open, not just every time it opens. So with that wait 60 seconds command, then I add an if statement. If the mini fridge contact sensor is still open after those 60 seconds, then I have a push cuts notification. It'll trigger the notification to send to my phone, and I'll know that the mini fridge has been left open. So if you want to do everything just in the home app, push cuts again is a great way to do that. While we're out here on the patio, I've been trying to make my pool a little smarter, not only with robots, but Cactuarly sent me this 7-in-1 pool sensor. It does have a micro USB port to charge it, but it also has a solar panel on top, and it's kept itself charged every day. I never have to worry about charging it again. After I spent some time calibrating it for chlorine and pH, I can now jump into the app for the pool sensor. It does require a small hub that you have to have connected nearby, but now I can get all this data on my pool at a glance. I can see the temperature of the water, the pH, the salt levels, and a bunch of other data for this 7-in-1 sensor. I did test these numbers against actually taking a sample down to Pinch a Penny and seeing what they said, and I find the numbers that the 7-in-1 sensor provides is very accurate. You can go in and see historical data for pH and other levels. We actually have a saltwater pool, so you can see that information here as well. And overall, it's just been nice to check these numbers whenever I want without having to get a bunch of chemicals out, water samples, and all that stuff. Also out here on the patio, I have multiple sensors, like this Eve weather, which will tell me the temperature outside, and combine that with the Eve motion sensor, I can now run automations based on motion and temperature outside. For instance, if I walk outside and it's hot, I want the patio fans to turn on. Now, this particular automation is difficult to build in the actual home app. So actually in the Eve app, I've built this automation and then it transfers over. So if I go to the automations tab here in the Eve app, you can then go over to rules. That's what the Eve app calls automations. And one of the ones I created was patio fans if hot. What this does is I can choose a trigger and then a condition whether or not I want action to be taken. So the trigger here is the motion. This Eve motion sensor that's typically outside will detect motion. And as soon as it does, it's gonna run this conditional. Now I stated, if the temperature outside is above 77 degrees, which Florida summertime, it pretty much is most days, then it's actually gonna turn on my patio fans. But if the temperature is below 77 degrees, it will do nothing. And even though I created it here in the Eve app, it actually shows up here in the home app automation as well. Basically what the Eve app has to do is create a scene based on those conditionals, but it's right here, I can enable it or disable it here in the home app and even select more accessories and scenes if I wanted to. Number 8, I have water leak sensors all over the house. These Aqara water leak sensors do require an Aqara hub. You can get an E1 and a water leak sensor for $43 for both of those. And these I place under pretty much every sink in the house. I have had times where water leak was detected. Once was actually a problem with a pipe and so thankfully got that fixed. Sometimes it was just a drippy pipe underneath the sink. And this will give you a warning on your phone. It's a critical alert in HomeKit, and then you can take care of the water leak. So love these things, I put them everywhere. You can see it show up here in the home app as a leak sensor. Expand it, and it basically says a simple leak detected, yes or no. You do get the battery level here, and I've found that these batteries last almost forever. I don't know if I've ever changed a battery in one of these Aqara water leak sensors. All right, number 9, I have another contact sensor. This is in my kids' bathroom. They have a tendency to leave the bathroom lights on even when they leave and are not in there. So I put a contact sensor at the bottom of the door, and then I have this automation. When the kids' bathroom door opens, this is another Aqara P2 contact sensor, and I do have it wait a few seconds because if they open the door and they're just trying to get out, I don't want to shut the lights off on them that fast. So I have it wait 15 seconds, and then it turns off the lights in the bathroom. And if they go into the bathroom, turn on the lights, but leave the door open, this won't run. This only runs if they had the door closed and then are leaving the bathroom, and it will shut the lights off so they're not left on all day. You can also combine that with a motion detector for when motion stops being detected, but I would recommend doing conditionals because oftentimes if you're very still in a room, motion sensors will say no motion detected and just shut the lights off on you. Now you might have heard of the Aqara presence sensor, and I actually have one, but have not gotten it to work super well. So I typically don't use it in automations, waiting for an updated version or some firmware updates to integrate it more. All right, number 10, if you have a garage, I highly recommend getting a garage camera. I actually have an Aqara G2H camera just sitting in the garage. It's a great way to tell if the garage is open or closed. Right now it's dark, so I know it's closed. But the great part about HomeKit cameras, especially HomeKit Secure Video, is each camera actually acts as a motion sensor as well. So this garage cam, which is the Aqara G2H, actually has a motion sensor that you can then automate. So when motion is detected in the garage, or you can program any of your cameras for when motion is detected, you can then build automations off that. I also like having a camera in the garage because then I can have a quick glance as whether or not the door is actually open or closed. I do use the Maris sensor and garage door opener, and it's pretty accurate telling me whether or not it's closed, but I have had some false positives where you have to kind of open and close it again to reset it. So I just like having the camera there for peace of mind. So those are 10 of my favorite automations for HomeKit sensors, but I want to give you one bonus shortcut, which when you have these sensors, pretty cool you can do. If I go to the Shortcuts app, I'm going to search for home, and I have this home status shortcut. If I expand, you can see what this does. It's actually getting the current state of different contact sensors, like the garage. I have a contact sensor on my utility room door, the patio, and you can add as many as you would like. Then I have a little text block here that basically tells me the status of each door or lock and shows that to me in Quick Look. So when I run this shortcut, I'll actually be able to know, is the garage closed or open? I can see right there, utility door closed, patio door locked. And that's actually the Yale Smart Lock giving me that status, but you can also add a contact sensor. Then you can customize this for all of your contact sensors, even motion sensors, and it's a great way to create just kind of a current home status. If you want to learn more about building that shortcut or more shortcuts, let me know down in the comments. I actually just published a shortcuts request video. You can check it out right up here. And I have an entire playlist of just requests from you where I built those shortcuts. I'll link that video down below. And if you want a complete tour of my 2024 smart home with over 100 HomeKit devices, I'll put my full tour video right up here. Don't forget to subscribe before you go, hit that like button, and thank you for watching. I'll catch you next time.